See now, problem number six, it's a 24 mark problem. Following is the trail balance of Karthik Bank Limited as on March 2016. So now trail balance is given. So one by one we have to discuss here. First one, paid up capital 50,000 equity share. Paid up capital 50,000 equity share, credit balance mentioned 5 lakh rupees. So this is schedule number one. This you can enter in schedule number one in the balance sheet. Reserve fund. So reserve fund 2,50,000 rupees. Reserve fund schedule number two. Then loans, cash credits and overdraft, debit balance 2,85,000. Now can you tell me the schedule number here for loans, cash credit and overdraft, where we have to enter this information? Can anyone tell me? Loans, cash credits, overdraft. Can you tell me the schedule number here? Yes, tell me. Can you comment in the chat box? Anyone? Schedule number for loans, advances and overdraft. You can unmute yourself and you can give the answer here. So whether it is a part of balance sheet or whether it is a part of profit and loss account, loans, advance and overdraft, tell me. Schedule number 6, Pratish is saying schedule number 6. Okay, schedule number 6 is regarding cash in hand. Cash in hand and balance with RBI. So there you cannot enter loans, advance and overdraft. Any other answer here? So you can consider this under schedule number 9. Schedule number 9, there you have to write loans, advances and overdraft information, debit balance. Now premises, see this is very simple. Premises, can you tell me the schedule number here where we have to consider premises? We know premise is a fixed asset, so where we have to enter this information? Can you tell me here? Premises in balance sheet, where we have to enter premises? Anyone? Schedule number 10. Schedule number 10, there you have to write premises. Then Indian government security. Indian government security is investment made by the bank. Indian government security is an investment made by the bank. Again, where you have to consider this? Can you give the schedule number here? Indian government security in balance sheet, where? Banking company accounts we are doing. So here you should know the schedule numbers, that is very important. So investment schedule number is 8. 8 is investment schedule number. There you can consider Indian government securities. Then current deposit, fixed deposit, saving bank deposit, recurring deposit. So now there are 4 types of deposit is given: current, fixed, saving, recurring. Balance is given in the credit side. See this. So now what we have to do? So this is the trail balance of the bank. So now we can assume that it is a deposit with the bank. So whenever it is a deposit with the bank, so that you can enter in schedule number 3. Schedule number 3, there is a specific schedule is there for deposit. There you can enter all this information. Next, salary. Salary, general expense, rent, rate and taxes, director fee. Four items here, balance given, debit balance is mentioned here. Now can you tell me here where we have to enter salary, director fee and all other expenses? See this, rent, rate and taxes and other information, where we have to enter? So this is schedule number 16. Yes, this is 24 mark problem. So this is schedule number 16 you have to consider. Schedule number 16, salary, general expense, rent rate and taxes, director fee, you have to consider under schedule number 16, operating expenses. Then profit and loss account as on 1/4/2015, this is nothing but profit and loss brought forward. There you can write under P&L account, third part, profit and loss after writing net profit or loss for the present year, previous year net profit or loss brought forward. There you can consider this information. So it is very easy. There you can directly enter 16,000. Next, interest and discount credit balance. Interest and discount credit balance is given. That is nothing but you can say it is interest and discount earned by the bank. Interest and discount earned by the bank. So that is why it is schedule number 13. Schedule number 13 is for interest earned under income, interest earned, P&L schedule. This is a P&L schedule. Then bills discounted and purchased, that is together debit balance is given, that is 46,000. So this is schedule number 9. Schedule number 9 you have to write. Stock of stationery, other asset. Other asset schedule number 11, 8,000. Commission and exchange, 8,000 credit balance. So this is other income for the bank. Commission, exchange, brokerage, that is other income earned by the bank. So schedule number 14. Schedule number 14, you can consider this. Then interim dividend paid. Okay. So interim dividend paid, what you have to do? There is one adjustment in this problem for interim dividend that we have to see. Then shares. Shares debit balance is there, 50,000. So now what happens? Share is an investment made by the bank. Schedule number 8. Schedule number 8, you have to consider share information. Interim dividend, there is an adjustment we have to see. So interim dividend in the sense dividend paid somewhere in between the year. Then cash in hand and with RBI. This is schedule number 6. This is schedule number 6, 1,93,000. Money at call and short notice, that is schedule number 7. That is cash with other banks. Cash with other banks and money at call and short notice, schedule number 7. There you can consider. Then balance with other bank also same schedule number 7, 30,000. So now total of the trail balance, if you see here, total of the trail balance 11,89,000. Now after this there is 8 adjustment is given. So one by one adjustment also we have to see here. So if you see, provision for bad and doubtful debts required 3,000. So adjustment appears twice usually. So now what happens here? You can consider this provision for bad debts after schedule number 16. After schedule number 16, under provision and contingency, bad debt you can write once in P&L account. Then next thing you have to do, the same bad debt you can deduct from schedule number 9 in the balance sheet. From the loans and advances, bad debts can be reduced. Then interest accrued on investment, that is 8,000. So now what do you mean by interest accrued? What it interest accrued means, it is outstanding interest. Interest accrued is outstanding interest. It is not paid. So you can add to the schedule number 13. Schedule number 13, you can add this information. Then schedule number 11, that is other asset. Their interest accrued on investment amount you can write. Two times it comes, one in schedule number 13 and one more is in schedule number 11. Then unexpired discount 2,000. So unexpired discount is equal to discount earned but not received. Discount earned but not received, or discount received in advance, or unexpired discount is also known as rebate on bills discounted. So rebate on bills discounted treatment we know, that is from schedule number 13, you have to deduct rebate on bills discounted and you have to write that amount, rebate on bills discounted or unexpired discount, in schedule number 5, that is other liabilities and provision in the balance sheet. Then interim dividend declared was 4% actual. There is one interim dividend is given in the balance. Now again they have mentioned interim dividend in the balance sheet. So 4% actual on what interim dividend is paid? On share capital dividend is calculated. So share capital we want. So share capital information is given in this. See this paid up capital 50,000 equity share, that is 5 lakh rupee. So 5 lakh rupees into 4% you do. So you will get a 20,000. So 20,000 is the dividend amount, but here interim dividend paid mentioned, that is only 17,000. That means 3,000 dividend is yet to be given. 3,000 rupees dividend is yet to be paid. So you can say that is unclaimed dividend. Unclaimed dividend, you can consider that under other liabilities and provision, you can consider unclaimed dividend. Then next thing, endorsement on behalf of customer. Endorsement on behalf of customer is contingent liability. So it is schedule number 12. Schedule number 12, you have to write this information. Then rupees 10,000 were added to the premises during the year. So premises total balance given in the trail balance, if you see premises, that is 50,000. That means out of this 50,000, 10,000 is added during this year. Depreciation is calculated on the opening balance of 5% that is required. That means 50,000 minus addition. 50,000 minus addition, that is 10,000, remaining 40,000, on that you have to take depreciation amount. Then depreciation you can show in schedule number 16, operating expenses. Then remaining amount you can directly show in schedule number 10, that is fixed asset. So like that you have to analyze here, adjustment. Then market value of government security, 4,20,000. So now here if you see securities information, Indian government security given in the trail balance 4 lakh, book value is 4 lakh, market value is 4,20,000. Which one we should consider? So market value can be considered only when there is profit and loss on revaluation information is given. So in this problem it is not mentioned, so that is why we can consider only the book value. Book value is 4 lakh given, so that we can consider. Make a provision for statutory reserve at 20%. So 20% on net profit. So net profit we know that is nothing but part 3 total, P&L part 3 total net profit. There you will take 20%. Then that is separately kept for statutory reserve purpose. Then if you see, there are several notes are given to this problem, that is answer solution part. If you see note number 1, so what is this note number 1? If you see, that is regarding unexpired discount. So unexpired discount is nothing but, if you see here, unexpired discount means rebate on bills discounted. So both are same. If in the problem they have mentioned unexpired discount, that is same, rebate on bills discounted, both are same. It is deducted from interest and discount, that is schedule number 13, and shown under other liabilities and provisions, schedule number 5. So there are two times you have to enter this information. Then endorsement on behalf of the customer is a contingent liability, schedule number 12. Then provision for doubtful debt should be shown on the provisions and contingency in P&L and should be deducted from loans, cash, credits and overdraft, schedule number 9. So that is one more note you can see. Now very important here in this problem, interim dividend note. Interim dividend calculation, if you see, that is actual interim dividend declared 4% on the capital. So capital is 5 lakh, 5 lakh into 4% amounts to 20,000, but interim dividend paid is 17,000. That means 20,000 minus 17,000, 3,000 is not paid, yet to be paid. So that is unpaid dividend. 3,000 is unpaid dividend. So 20,000 should be shown under appropriation. That means in the part 4 of profit and loss account, under appropriation, after transfer to statutory reserve, after transfer to other reserve, there is transfer to proposed dividend. There you can enter this information, 20,000 rupees full amount, 5 lakh into 4%. Then that remaining 3,000 not paid, that you can show under other liabilities and provision, schedule number 5. So that is unclaimed dividend. Then market value of government security stated 420,000. The profit or loss on revaluation should be taken into account in the case of bank decided to show it at a market value. But here profit and loss on revaluation not mentioned in the problem. That is why we can't take market value of government security. We have to take the book value of government security. So these are the information regarding the problem, trail balance and all other adjustment. Now first thing we have to do, step number one, preparation of schedules to profit and loss account. So now one by one we have to see, there are four schedules to profit and loss account, 13, schedule number 13 to schedule number 16. So now schedule number 13, if you see, there is interest and discount earned by the bank, interest and discount earned by the bank, credit balance in trail balance. Trail balance is mentioned, so that is 120,000 directly you can consider here. But there is accrued interest given in the adjustment. Accrued interest, if you see, that is 8,000 rupees. So you can add that outstanding interest to interest on interest and discount. So that is 8,000 less unexpired discount. Why we have to deduct unexpired discount? It is discount earned but not received. It is a discount of the next year. So discount of the next year we cannot consider in this year. That is why you have to deduct this unexpired discount or rebate on bills discounted. That is 2000. This is also given in the adjustment. So now schedule number 13 total we want. Schedule number 13 total 120,000 plus 8,000 minus 2000. Total is 126,000. Next, schedule number 14. Schedule number 14, commission and brokerage earned by the bank. So that is nothing but other incomes of the bank. So other income, only one information, 8,000. Directly you can write schedule number 14. Schedule number 15, in this problem not there. Why? Because it is interest paid by the bank. Interest paid by the bank on saving bank account, interest paid by the bank on fixed deposit account, recurring deposit account, it is not there. But deposit information is given, but interest paid information is not there. That is why interest spended by the bank, schedule number 15, nil, no value here. Then schedule number 16, salary. Salaries need to be paid by the bank to the employees, so that is 28,000. Operating expenses, some of the general expenses, again in given in the trail balance, 27,000. Operating expenses, rent, rates and taxes, rent of the building, rate and taxes together they have given, that is 3,000. Again it is operating expenses. Director fee, director's remuneration, that is 2,000. Again operating expenses. Depreciation of immovable property, so here premises depreciation is mentioned. So depreciation of immovable property we want. So here 2000, how we got this 2000? So now we have to calculate here. So if you see premises total, that is 50,000. 50,000 into rate you have to see. Now rate, what is the rate here? 5%. 50,000 into 5%, what is the amount? 50,000 into 5%, it is 2500. It is 2500, but here we have written 2000. Why? Because in the adjustment they have mentioned, what they have mentioned here in the adjustment, see this, depreciation should be charged on the opening balance. That means from the total given in the trail balance 50,000, you have to deduct 10,000 which is added during this year. So 50,000 minus 10,000, 40,000. 40,000 into 5% now you do. So now you will get 2,000. Depreciation is 2,000, 40,000 into 5%. So now schedule number 16 total. Schedule number 16 total we want. So that is salary 28,000, general expenses 27,000, rent, rates and taxes 3,000, director fee 2,000, depreciation 2,000. Add all this, you will get 62,000. Next, provisions and contingency, there is no schedule number. We all know for provisions and contingency there is no schedule number. In this problem there is bad debt. Provision for bad debt information is given, that is provisions and contingency, there you can consider. Directly you can write the amount. See this 3,000, where it is mentioned? It is mentioned here. See this adjustment. Adjustment they have mentioned 3,000. So you can consider. Similarly, if there is a provision for taxation, In this question, they have not given you provision for taxation. If provision for taxation is there, then also you can consider under provisions and contingency, and you can consider that income tax again in schedule number 5, that is other liabilities and provision. So that is regarding provisions and contingency. Now we have prepared the first step, that is schedule 2 profit and loss account. So I hope everyone understood till here. Now next thing, main format we have to do. Main format of profit and loss account is required. So now we know there are 4 schedules, isn't it? 4 schedules. So there are 4 parts as well. So profit and loss account for the year ending 31/3/2016, particular schedule number amount. So now first we will treat income calculation, income earned by the bank. So now first is interest earned, schedule number 13, interest earned schedule number 13. Now you see schedule number 13 total under schedules to profit and loss account, schedule number 13 total is 1,26,000. Same 1,26,000 is to be entered in the main format. Yes, then interest earned is over. Then other income, that is schedule number 14. So schedule number 14, that is only one information, commission and exchange 8,000. Directly you can consider here. Then we want total of income, that is interest earned plus other income, 13 plus 14 total, that is 1,26,000 plus 8,000, 1,34,000. So income total we got. Now expenditure, interest expended by the bank, that is not there in this question, schedule number 15 is nil. Operating expenses, if you see operating expenses total, if you see the schedules to profit and loss account, you will come to know total is 62,000. 62,000 you can consider here under operating expenses, schedule number 16. Then provisions and contingencies, what happens, provisions for and contingency here, 3,000 is given. So same 3,000 you can write, but there is no schedule number. Under schedule number column you have to put dash. There is no schedule number for provisions and contingency. This is very important. Then you have to make the total of expenditure, that is 15 plus 16, interest expended plus operating expenses plus provisions and contingency. These three total we want. That is nothing but 62,000 plus 3,000, 65,000. Now expenditure total we got. Now third part is profit and loss account. Third one is profit and loss account. So now we want to know whether income more or expenditure is more in this problem. So now we have to compare these two total. See this. Total of income is 1,34,000. Total of expense is 65,000. That means here income is more. Income is more in the sense there is net profit for the year. Net profit is there for this current year. So net profit, how to calculate? Income minus expense. 1,34,000 income total minus expenditure total. Expenditure total is 65,000. So deduct. So if you deduct these two, you will get the difference amount. Difference amount is 69,000. See this, 69,000. That is net profit for the year. So net profit for the year we got, that is 69,000. Next we have to add to this net profit the profit or loss of the previous year. Profit or loss information of the previous year. If you see the previous problems, there they have not mentioned regarding profit and loss brought forward of the previous year. But if you see this trail balance information, there is one statement given here. Somewhere it is mentioned. See this, profit and loss on 1/4/2015, 16,000 rupees. So this is the trail balance prepared. If you see March 2016. So this is the trail balance prepared at the end of the financial year, and this P&L account is balance is given at the beginning of the financial year. So we know that this is the previous year profit and loss account balance. So closing balance, we know it becomes opening balance of the next year. So we can assume that this balance 1/4/2015 is the balance for the year 2014-15. 2014-15 in the sense 1/4/2014 till 31/3/2015. Then that is transferred to this trail balance. So now 16,000 you have to add here. 16,000 you have to consider to this net profit for the year 69,000 we got. Add profit and loss brought forward 16,000. Now make the total. Part 3 total, that is 69,000 plus 16,000, 85,000. Yes. Next, part 4. Part 4 is appropriation. Appropriation we have to see here. First, from the net profit 20%. This is the rule under section 17 of the Banking Company Regulation Act 1949. Out of the net profit, 20% shall be transferred to statutory reserve. That means out of this 85,000, this total 85,000 into 20% you take. 85,000 into 20%, you will get 17,000. So this is the transfer made to statutory reserve, and this balance you have to show in schedule number 2. Schedule number 2 of the balance sheet, there you have to show statutory reserve separately and you have to show balance carried over to balance sheet separately. So we have considered that. Then transfer to other reserve, other special reserve, capital reserve, not there, nil. Next we have to consider here, transfer to proposed dividend. See this, transfer or proposed dividend. Here proposed dividend information given in the adjustment. So now what we have to do, we have to see the adjustment here. Adjustment they have mentioned. Yes, see this, interim dividend was declared 4% actual. So actually you have to write this interim dividend information under proposed dividend column, because there is no proposed dividend information is given. So what you have to do, from this share capital 5 lakh rupee, paid up capital 5 lakh rupee, 5 lakh rupee into 4%, so that is nothing but 20,000. So that 20,000 you can consider here. Yes, same thing we have written here. See this, 20,000, 5 lakh into 4% proposed dividend. Next we want balance carried over to balance sheet. So balance carried over to balance sheet is nothing but part 3 total, that is profit and loss account total 85,000 minus transfer to statutory reserve 17,000. Transfer to statutory reserve 17,000, then minus proposed dividend 20,000. So that is nothing but 85,000 minus 17,000 minus 20,000. You will get the balancing figure. Balancing figure is 48,000. So this 48,000 is the balance carried over to balance sheet, should be shown under schedule number 2 of banking companies main balance sheet format. So now finally we want total. So if you see the total here, total is nothing but part 3 total itself. Part 3 total itself is the part 4 total or the final P&L account total, that is 85,000. So this is regarding P&L calculation. So now any questions, any doubts you can ask me here. Yes, tell me. Have you all understood? Question, any doubts regarding this? Ashish is saying no. Rajat is saying no. I hope everyone is understood this. So thank you. We'll meet in the next class. We'll continue the problem in the next class. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you.